The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall, setting up shop as usual... And my stock in trade, as usual, is the unusual. I can offer you the unknown, the unexpected, and even the unearthly. It happens. Indeed, it happens to everyone. You find yourself in a strange city, and yet something inside you whispers, I have been here before. You see a strange face, but... Why is it so oddly familiar? They say history repeats itself. Therefore, we must repeat ourselves. If we are here now, then it follows we have been here before. And we shall be here again.
Come in, sir. Have a seat.
Thank you. You are Senor Barlow?
Yes, sir. Call me Pete. Now, I'd like to show
you... I must make sure that you are Pete Barlow.
You can ask my secretary. I'm Pete Barlow, sales manager for the development. And let me tell you, sir, this is a blue-chip investment. You'll double your money in 5 years.
I have not come here to buy land, Senor Barlow.
You haven't? Then why are you here?
I have come to collect a debt.
A debt?
That is correct, senor.
What do you claim I owe you?
You owe me your heart.
Our mystery drama, The Golden Blood of the Sun, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars John Forsythe and Rita Gamm. It is sponsored in part by Contact, the 12-hour cold capsule, and Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, brewers of Budweiser. I'll be back shortly with Act One. They look down upon us from the walls of the museums, from the ruins of temples. Those men and women who came before us in time. And what do we see when we gaze back? What do their faces tell us? We cannot say, because we no longer dream the dreams, nor do we see the visions of our ancestors. True, the past is preserved for us in stone and in bronze and on canvas, but it is merely the outer shell of the past. Where is the soul, the spirit, the beating heart? Especially the beating heart.
Yeah, the forecast is for rain again this weekend. Well, don't ask me what we're going to do. I'm just giving you the facts. Hold it, Bob, my other phone. Yes, Millicent, what is it? Send him in. Bob, I'll call you back. Right now I have to talk with the golden boy himself. Sit down, Peter.
Mr. Valentine, let's have this out right now. I know you don't like me.
I don't dislike you, Peter.
I know I wasn't your choice for general sales manager.
That's true. Peter, we go by the record. And the record shows sales are down. Way down since you took over.
Well, we're selling a sun country resort. We're selling glorious weather. We simply haven't had any of that lately. We've had rain for the past 8 weekends in a row. Now, is that my fault?
Probably.
What are you saying?
Cause and effect. Before you came, we hardly ever had rain. Since you arrived, we've had nothing but. You could very well be a jinx.
Do you mean to tell me that you believe...
Peter, you're not a bad guy. You're even a pretty good salesman, but you're in the wrong place.
Well, you've been trying to get rid of me since the day I arrived.
Peter, why do you insist on making this personal? You just aren't a sun country man. Go back home. You could do great in that ski development area, northern New England.
I can do great anywhere. I can sell anybody. I can sell anything. But I can't sell people if they don't show up. And they won't show up if it rains.
Exactly. Now, why suddenly does it rain here every weekend? The answer is you.
Mr. Valentine, you've stopped being funny.
I'm being scientific.
You have scientifically determined that I am the cause of the weekend rains?
Almost. But in all scientific investigation, a control is needed.
A control?
Exactly. We must establish what happens when you're not here. So take the weekend off.
What?
Go to Mexico City. Have a ball. The company will pick up the tab.
But the weekend is when I should be here selling.
Selling? To whom? Who comes in the rain? Now, this is Thursday, right?
Yes.
Suppose you go to Mexico City tomorrow morning, and we wind up having a beautiful sunny weekend here. Would that prove something?
My contract calls for me to be here every weekend.
Not if I send you to Mexico City on business.
What kind of business?
There's a Senor Mendoza who owns some property. We may buy it for a resort hotel. Go there. Look it over. Give me your opinion.
Well, I've never been to Mexico City.
Great. You'll have the time of your life. It's just over the mountains. Take the company plane.
I suppose I get there, and it rains here anyhow.
That's what we want to find out, isn't it?
Senor Barlow?
Yes?
Welcome to Mexico City. My father, Senor Mendoza, sent me to meet you.
How do you do?
My name is Irina.
Mine is Peter.
Please come with me. I have the car. You'll be our guest.
Oh, I made a reservation at our hotel here.
No, my father insists.
Oh, that's very kind of him.
You will be wined, you will be dined, entertained.
That won't be hard to take.
And you will probably decide to advise your company to buy the estate.
What makes you so sure?
Because you will fall in love with it.
How do you know that?
Everyone does. And yet, I hope you will decide against buying it.
You do? Why?
This is the car.
Why do you hope I'll decide against buying it?
Do you like music?
Love it.
Then let's have some.
And now, why do you hope I'll decide against buying it?
I happen to be in love with it.
That's a very good reason.
But we must sell it. We need the money.
Yes, well, money in the end becomes best of all reasons.
Why do you keep staring at me?
Was I staring?
Yes.
Well, you're probably the prettiest girl in Mexico City.
You were staring as if you knew me.
How could I know you? I've never been here before.
What I don't understand is you look familiar to me, too. As if I knew you a long time ago.
Well, I'll tell you what that is. There are just so many basic facial types in the world. So a great many people are going to look alike.
I don't mean that. I have the feeling that I knew you once. Gold Eagle!
Hold my hand, dearest one. Don't be frightened.
Will they kill us, Gold Eagle?
No, they would have killed us during the raid. See, they're being kind to us.
Why? And where are they taking us?
They're taking us to their city, to Tenochtitlan. Tenochtitlan.
What are you saying?
Who? Oh, me? Nothing.
But you are. You keep on muttering. Tenochtitlan.
What?
Yes, Tenochtitlan.
I can't even say it.
You mean you've never heard that name before?
Is it a name?
Yes, Tenochtitlan. It was the ancient Aztec name for Mexico City.
What is that again?
Tenochtitlan. But why should you keep repeating it over and over?
I have no idea. I guess it's just another one of those crazy things that seems to be happening to me ever since I came to this country.
Irina, Senor Barlow's plate is empty. Please help him to some more.
No, thank you, Senor Mendoza. No more of anything.
If we are going to show Senor Barlow the estate, we should. His time is valuable.
I can assure you, Senor, I'm in no hurry.
The story is told of the gods, the ancient gods of this country, the greatest god of all, the supreme god of the Aztecs.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It is nothing.
Such a beautiful, delicate coffee cup. I'm so sorry.
But this was its ordained fate.
I don't understand how I could have dropped it.
No one lives. Nothing lasts forever.
What? What did you say?
I said, if I can remember. If I can remember. Our lives, Gold Eagle, must reconcile the opposites, age and youth, good and evil. We are born only that we may die.
But not to die young.
You are willing to die young to defend your city against us? Will you die young for your god?
Tezcatlipoca is not my god. He is the god of the Aztec. He is your god.
He is the supreme god of all Mexico. He is the mighty, the immortal, the magnificent Tezcatlipoca. Come, come, Gold Eagle. If he needs a few drops of blood, whose blood is it? Yours? It was always his.
I will not accept Tezcatlipoca. I will not.
Another cup of coffee, Senor Barlow?
Senor Barlow? Father, is something wrong with him?
Tezcatlipoca. Tezcatlipoca.
Senor.
What is it? Yes.
Why do you keep saying Tezcatlipoca?
What am I saying?
Over and over again, Tezcatlipoca. What does that name mean to you?
Nothing. I don't know who or what it is. I never heard of it.
Tezcatlipoca is the supreme god of the Aztecs.
Really?
The god of the sun.
The sun?
Now, why should you, a perfect stranger in this country, keep saying the name of the ancient sun god? Have you ever studied the history of the ancient Mexican people?
No. Well, the truth is, I'm really not very much of a history student.
While you were saying this name, were you looking at anything?
I don't know what you mean.
Well, it could have been a dream. Therefore, you might have been somewhere talking to someone.
No. Oh, wait. Wait, I seem to be aware of a golden glow.
Uh-huh. And?
And that's all.
Have you... I don't even know how to say this, but have you had any unusual thoughts about the sun lately?
The sun? It's odd that you should bring that up, but I've been accused...
Yes, you've been accused...
You know the resort that my company is developing in the valley?
Yes.
How often does it rain in that part of the world normally?
Well, a few sprinkles, perhaps, over the course of a year.
There have been steady downpours for the past 8 weekends.
Oh, no. No, I find that impossible to believe.
My project manager holds me responsible.
For the rain?
Yes, the man says that I'm a jinx. He sent me here to prove that with me gone, there'll be sunshine back at the project.
Excuse me. Hello?
Mr. Peter Barlow, please.
One moment. Senor Barlow.
Thank you. Oh, hello?
Peter?
Yeah? Oh, yes, Mr. Valentine.
I thought you'd want to know. There's been a sudden shift in the weather. Not a cloud in sight. We've got a brilliant gold sun in a deep blue sky. How about that?
About that indeed. You may say coincidence. Then I may ask, what is a coincidence? Mr. Webster says it's an accidental concurrence of unrelated events. Very good. But is there truly such a thing as an accident? Aren't all things, great and small in this world, somehow tied together? Not by accident, but by design. I shall return shortly with Act Two. How would you like to be Peter Barlow, a bright young man selling land in a Mexican resort, and discover that somehow you had upset the sun. Well, superstition may be superstition, but evidence is evidence. When Peter is in the area, it rains. When he's absent, there's sunshine. You can count on it. You can predict it. You can even bet on it.
Yes, indeed, Peter. We're having beautiful weather. The crowds are pouring in.
But
I've already squared it with New York. You've been transferred to the New England ski development.
You mean that the weather is sunny out at the development?
It's gorgeous. How's the weather in Mexico City?
It looks cloudy.
Frankly, Peter, I think you ought to run our hotels in London. See you around.
Bye. Well, I don't know what to say. The weather has just turned great in the valley.
Well, I'm sure it's...
My dear, in this world, can we be sure of anything? I think we had better ride out to the estates.
It's a lovely country.
Yes. At one time, my family owned a great deal of it. Now we just have the estate near Cuernavaca. Have you ever been there?
No, I'm afraid I've never even heard of it.
You never heard of the famous Cuernavaca?
No.
Well, perhaps you knew it by its ancient name of Guanajuac.
Well, what makes you think I would know that?
Well, you seem to have a knowledge of ancient Mexican names.
Well, I'm not aware of it. I don't know
think,
how...
Think. The name. Guanajuac.
But I never...
Just think.
What are you trying to...
I'm trying to help you.
Help me? To do what?
I don't know. What is it that you feel you must do?
I don't feel I have to do anything.
That is not true.
Why do you say that?
Father?
Yes, my dear?
We'll be passing near the temple. Shall we stop?
Yes, yes. It might be interesting for Senor Barlow.
Well, I'm not much for sightseeing, but if it's interesting...
It does not look like very much right now, but the most dramatic of all the ceremonies took place right there.
Oh, what kind were they?
Human sacrifice.
Sounds barbaric.
In this temple, the high priest of Tezcatlipoca stood ready with the knife made of glass, black glass, and he would cut out the heart of the victim.
That's not barbaric?
Oh, there was no pain. Death was immediate.
Yes, but the whole idea is...
Your idea, perhaps. But it was a ritual of a people whose civilization is not to be despised.
There's the temple, Father.
Yes, yes, by the side of the lake. In the old days, they would arrive by boat. A very joyous procession.
That's the temple, that crumbling heap of stones?
It was never a splendid place. It was used just once during the year and for one purpose only. It was never taken care of. Hardly ever repaired. All that was needed was the stairway leading to a chamber at the top where an altar of stone and a priest with a knife of glass waited. Gold Eagle.
Yes.
We have arrived. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Say goodbye now to Soft Cloud.
No, he must not go.
Children, this was agreed to.
Why must he die?
He will not die. He becomes part of the body and the spirit, the flesh and the blood of Tezcatlipoca.
No!
Are you a royal princess or a slave girl? You know your duty.
Don't go, Gold Eagle. Refuse.
Refuse?
They can't compel him.
Oh, yes. Yes, you may refuse, Gold Eagle, and spend the rest of your life as a slave.
But it will be life.
And you will spend every lifetime till eternity as a fugitive from the wrath of Tezcatlipoca.
You have no right to say anything. It is for him to decide.
He has already agreed. Gold Eagle.
His heart will be of no use to Tezcatlipoca if he is not freely given.
The sun is about to reach its highest point. You must decide, Gold Eagle. At this moment,
We must know your decision.
Save yourself. Save yourself.
Speak.
I don't know. I don't know what to do.
Are you interested in seeing the temple, Senor Barlow? Senor Barlow.
I don't know what to do.
Father? Father, what is wrong with
you? Senor Barlow, are you all right?
I don't know what to do.
It isn't the first time, Father. He seems to be off somewhere else and says things you just can't understand.
I don't know what to do,
Senor Barlow.
I must have dozed off.
No, Senor. You were having a nightmare, or was it a hallucination?
I'm afraid I don't
Senor,
know.
Senor, something has happened to you since you arrived in this country?
Yes, I'm sure something has.
Irina, we shall not visit the estate today. Turn back to the city. Senor Barlow must see a doctor.
A doctor? No.
Why not?
Because I'm all right.
Is that true, Senor? Are you really all right?
Well, I find nothing wrong. Pressure's normal. Pulse. Temperature. I've taken some blood tests, but I have no reason to suspect anything.
What is wrong with me, Doctor?
On the face of it, nothing. You seem to be excited.
Excited? That's not the half of it. My whole career is down the drain.
Oh, you're not even 30. How can you make a statement like that?
I stake my future in this development company. I was building toward the top, but now it's all over. I'm through here.
You seem to have an affinity for the old, that is, the pre-Columbian Mexico. And you can't account for it.
No, sir. No way.
When did it start?
When I arrived here a few months ago.
And you've heard voices?
Yes, sir.
What were the voices saying?
Well, I seem to have been an Indian, a Quanahuac Indian. Now, don't ask me what that means. Don't even ask me where I heard the word. At first, they were just voices, but each day things become more and more clear.
How?
I see things.
Things?
Yes. A valley, a beautiful valley. There were lovely buildings, tall temples, babbling fountains, and everywhere graceful, handsome people. And I see myself walking with a man, an older man. My father.
Remember, my son, we are not warriors. We are singers. We are poets, painters, sculptors, craftsmen.
But the Aztec people, suppose they attack?
Then we shall fight as best we can.
Exactly, father. Therefore, shouldn't we teach our young men the arts of war?
Good Eagle, if we do so, then we shall become a nation of warriors. And thus, we shall have lost our culture in any event.
But it seems unfair.
No, the Aztecs will not destroy us. They raid us on occasion only because they must.
They must?
Yes. To keep the sun in the sky, they must sacrifice to him. And the sun god, the Tezcatlipoca, accepts only the purest hearts. There are not enough of these among the Aztec people, so they must come to us.
I still say we must fight them.
I agree, but the best way to fight one's enemy is to be better than he is, and more worthy and precious to the gods.
Father, I cannot doubt your wisdom, but...
Doubt, my son. Doubt any man, but not the gods.
I cannot submit to the Aztec calmly.
You must.
I must.
It was foreseen at your birth, my son, that you would become a true child of Tezcatlipoca. Your blood would be his.
Me? A sacrifice to Tezcatlipoca?
We must not say sacrifice. A better and truer word would be gift. Yes, my son.
I don't understand. I don't understand. understand.
Peter.
No, I don't understand.
Peter. Peter?
Yes. Yes, what is it?
Where were you?
Where was I?
Yes. For at least a minute, your mind was somewhere else. Are you going to tell me you don't know?
Well, it's too fantastic. You wouldn't believe it.
Try me.
I was in Cuanahuac, the place I told you about.
Yes?
I'm young, I'm handsome, I'm everything a young prince should be. That's why my name is Gold Eagle. I soar above the crowd.
Well, that's a happy situation.
No, it isn't, because I'm fated to be captured by the Aztecs and sacrificed to the great god Tezcatlipoca.
At least that's a figment of your imagination.
How do I know so much about the mysterious past of a strange, unfamiliar country?
Well, there's a rational explanation.
Yes, what is it?
I don't know.
Well, then how can you say that...
The fact that I can't come up with an explanation right now doesn't mean that it doesn't exist, does it?
Doctor.
Yes?
Look outside your window. What do you see?
It's raining. That's impossible. We never get rain this time of year.
And I'll tell you something else. It'll rain for as long as I'm here. The sun god is angry.
Well, he gets in deeper and deeper, doesn't he? For a man who's never been in this part of the world before, he seems to know quite a bit about its past. But hold on. Who says he's never been here before? We only have his word for it. But how does he know? I'll return shortly with Act 3. Suddenly, there are visions of a past. A splendid but barbaric past. Why should a young American, with no real interest in anything else except a career and the normal things young men are concerned with, why should he suddenly see himself as a tragic Indian prince, a designated victim of an Aztec sacrifice? Why? Well, it's always easier to ask a question than to answer it, no?
I know myself, Doctor. I know that I'm not the kind of a person who gets delusions.
Actually, Mr. Barlow, you are.
Doctor, it's raining. I'm a very down-to-earth guy who
People
knows...
People like you are the ones who crack up first.
What do you mean, crack up?
Crack up, break down, it all comes to the same thing.
But I'm perfectly...
Yes? Perfectly what? Now, come now, Mr. Barlow. What's this nonsense about being in disfavor with the sun god and thereby causing rain?
The fact is, I am in disfavor with the sun god.
All right, let's hear those facts.
Now I know why. You see, the Aztecs did attack Cuanahuac. One night, when we were sleeping peacefully, they descended upon the city. I was taken prisoner.
What are you telling me?
I remember now. Prisoner. But I wasn't beaten. I wasn't tortured. I was treated like a prince. And I was taken to the high priest of the Aztecs.
Welcome, Gold Eagle.
You know my name.
Your name is known throughout Mexico. Will you give me your blessing?
What?
May I have your blessing?
My blessing? I'm your prisoner.
No, not a prisoner, Gold Eagle, but a guest. An honored guest. A divine guest.
Me?
Surely, Gold Eagle, you must know the prophecy. You are the earthly body of Tezcatlipoca.
No. Oh, no.
And this year you shall dwell among us to guide us, advise us, even rule us.
I don't understand.
Why not? You have his heart.
But I...
And at the end of the stated year, as it is commanded, you shall return his heart to him.
Holy One, you must listen. I am not worthy
of such... You are modest, which is good.
But suppose I refuse?
How can you refuse? Why should you refuse? We only live because the mighty sun god gives us his blood. Is it unreasonable to give him a few drops of ours in return?
But suppose I still refuse?
Then live your life, whatever shall be left of it, as a slave in the mines, shunned and despised.
Yes? Go on, Mr. Barlow.
And in the end, I agreed. I agreed to live as a hero. I was adored by an entire nation. Well, what's the point? You don't believe a word of it.
Do you?
If it didn't happen, where is it coming from?
Well, as I say, there has to be a rational explanation.
Let me ask you something. This old religion, does it still exist?
I don't have any hard evidence one way or another. But
what?
No religion ever dies out completely, especially one that had such a powerful hold over so many people.
Ah, then what you're saying is that there still could be some of this sun worship around here today.
A form of it, perhaps. Blended with the religions that came after it. Adapted to more modern times, of course.
Then there could be priests of this religion who...
Who what?
Who could be working on my mind somehow.
Tell me how.
I don't know how. Hypnotism, this whole thing about transfer of thoughts, you know, ESP.
Oh, granted, for the sake of argument, but how would they know about you? You, Peter Barlow.
I don't know. It seems to me that I came here for answers, not for questions. Thank you for picking me up, Irina.
My father wants you to come back to the house. He believes you should do nothing. Just rest.
I hate to impose.
Oh, it's nothing. It makes him very happy. But I will say something else.
Yes?
I will say you must not come back.
No?
No. Please, let me drive you to the airport.
The airport? But why?
You must get board a plane at once.
What is it, Irina?
Leave this country.
Why? Why do you say that?
Because I love you.
You what?
I love you.
But we only met yesterday.
No, I have always loved you.
Always? What do you mean by always?
My name is Soft Cloud.
Soft Cloud? How would you know the name?
I was given to you as a gift.
The gift?
That year of splendor. You could choose among all the princesses of Mexico for your consort. You chose me. You remember?
I'm going crazy.
None of this is a dream. Gold Eagle.
Gold Eagle? You even know that?
I have lived through it also. When the year ended, I couldn't bear to give you up. Give you up to the knife of black glass. And the sacrifice, so I persuaded you to refuse.
I remember. I went into the mines.
And I went with you.
And it wasn't long before, for I was no longer handsome, and you were no longer beautiful.
I remember.
And I died very soon after. I was very young, I remember.
Yes.
What am I saying I remember for? I don't remember any of it. This is just some funny fantasy running through my brain. That's it. It's a fantasy, a hallucination.
No, no.
My name is Peter. No, no.
Once again, I ask you to refuse the knife.
What knife?
The sharp black knife of glass that will enable your heart to be offered to the sun god.
Who's going to do that?
The high priest of the Aztec.
But that stuff died out hundreds of years ago.
Let us go to the airport. Peter, please. This time there are no mines, no slaves. We can live happily, perhaps this time.
I tell you what we should do. We should turn around and take you back to the doctor.
If you stay here, you'll die. Come in. I'll turn on the light.
What's in here?
Look. It's the chamber of the high priest himself. See? Here are the ceremonial headdresses, the robes, the ornaments of gold, and there...
I see.
...is the knife, the sharp and pointed knife of black glass.
To whom do these things belong?
I told you, Peter, to the high priest.
You talk of him as if he's still alive.
Still alive and very much alive. He's my father.
Your father? I don't believe any of this.
Peter, if you stay here, you'll die.
I can protect myself.
You will die willingly.
Oh, no, never.
It will seem right. You will become anxious to die. Please, Peter.
Ah, Peter. Interesting place, no?
Yes, sir.
It is my private museum. As you can see, so many of the artifacts of a forgotten civilization.
Forgotten?
Well, let us say, past.
I quite frankly don't know what's happened to me. Actually, since I came to this country, I'm not even sure who I am. Sometimes I...
How many people really know who they are?
Your daughter tells me that my life is in danger.
Danger?
Yes, that I'll die if I stay here. What do you say to that?
Well, that depends on what you mean by die.
Look, I was sent here to examine an estate you have for sale. May I see it now?
Are you well enough?
I'm fine, just fine. Somehow I got mixed up with some superstitious nonsense, but I can shut that out of my mind. Let's go.
As you wish.
Now, as I understand it, the estate is well over 1,000 acres.
Yes.
It has a lake.
Yes.
And that means a golf course could be...
Irina, my dear.
Yes, Father.
Stop here, please.
Why, Father?
Why? Isn't it obvious?
Father, no.
Why did we stop?
Look. Over there. To your left.
It's the temple.
I still don't know why we stopped.
To complete your bargain with the sun god?
Bargain? What bargain?
To pay your debt?
You're crazy.
Or am I? Come. Put on this white robe, this pure white robe, and we shall mount these steps to the sacred chamber.
Don't listen to him. Don't listen to him, Gold Eagle.
Gold Eagle?
Yes, yes, my son. You are Gold Eagle, and she is Soft Cloud. And I am the High Priest. And the three of us have been here before, and all of us have played our roles before. Come! Follow me. I am waiting.
Don't go! Don't go!
This is what she must say to you. She represents the flesh, the present, the here, the now. She is the temptation of the world. She is being true to her mission. She has convinced you in the past so many times in the past.
What do you mean, so many times?
The first time, when I was the Aztec high priest, and you were the golden captive of the Quanahuac. There have been other times since then. Do you remember?
No.
Tezcatlipoca waits. He has given you his blood, his heart. He waits for you to return him. He waits through all your lifetime.
No!
Soft Cloud, Irina, I love you, but I'm tired of escaping. I want to go back.
No.
Back where I belong, back to Tezcatlipoca.
Come with me.
Come with me, my son. Put on your white robe.
Gold Eagle.
Remember the first time, Soft Cloud. We came by boat, and the people followed us along the shore. And they were singing and cheering. For me, Tezcatlipoca. For me, the sun god. I was to return to my place in the sky.
Peter, please.
See the clouds? I must return.
My son, let us walk up the steps together to the sacred chamber.
Do you have the knife of black glass?
It is in my robe.
I give it my blessing.
The sun is starting to break through the clouds.
Very soon now, I shall be back in the sky. Priest, let us go forward. Priest, I have had a strange vision. I dreamed I had refused to be sacrificed.
You? You, Gold Eagle? Impossible.
I dreamed I was born again. In the future.
Indeed. A dream?
The future is a place of many wonders. And I had believed that the sun god no longer ruled. And then one day, he called to me.
Have you ever doubted the sun god?
Never.
We are here, Gold Eagle.
Be quick, priest. Be quick.
I'm sorry, there's no such person here.
Is this the home of Senor Mendoza?
Yes, I'm his daughter, Irina.
Well, a couple of weeks ago, I sent him to see your father's estate.
I know nothing about that.
Well, I called him there the day after he arrived. I spoke with him.
That's impossible, Senor. My father and I have been in Europe. We only returned home last evening.
But I made arrangements with Senor Mendoza for Mr. Barlow to see the estate.
I'm sorry, Senor. You must be mistaken.
Peter Barlow disappeared. He was never seen or even heard of again. And we really don't know what happened. Maybe the old religion survives. Or maybe Peter may have looked at Trina in a way that old man Mendoza didn't like. What's positive is the fact that this is a world of endless possibilities. The only sure thing is that I shall be back shortly. Other people, those who lived in the past. They were powered by other drives, other forces. They were people of faith, people of vision. Everything they built was for the glory of their gods. They will be remembered for their magnificent temples and their enduring belief. And what shall we be remembered for? Our cast included John Forsythe, Rita Gamm, Arnold Moss, and Barry Kroger. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. Now, a preview of our next tale.
What do you want?
I want things as they are right now.
I don't know what that means.
I want you to keep living in fear, filled with fright, worrying, wondering what I'm going to do about you.
That's all you want?
It's enough.
Why? What did I ever do to you?
What did you ever do to me? Oh, how dare you ask that?
I ask because I don't know.
You killed the man I loved.
The man you loved?
You killed Scott Partridge.
He didn't even know you were alive.
Does that matter? Can you live without the sun? Does the sun know you're alive?
You loved Scott.
Love? Oh, what a weak, fragile word. I adored him. I worshipped him. And you killed him.
This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.